Your presence here, let's just say it's highly irregular. Outsiders aren't even allowed to know that our bunker's here, let alone come and go freely. You impressed Elder McNamara, obviously. He must believe that you'd be very useful. That's right. Nothing gets in or out of here without me knowing it. Normally, that would have fallen under my jurisdiction, but the Elder thought it'd provide a good test for you, so I backed off. Under the lockdown, only essential personnel are permitted to enter or leave. That includes supply runners and high security patrols. All other personnel are forbidden to leave, and any personnel that were out there when the lockdown was enacted are forbidden from returning.
Just needs room to swing. He'll be back. Sure as a conga drum's got a groovy beat.
You know they say that no news is good news, but I think my program would be awfully dull if that were the case. Here's Bing Crosby reminding us of those times when you absolutely have to kiss the person you love. Something's gotta give.
It's me again, Mr. New Vegas, reminding you that you're nobody till somebody loves you, and that somebody is me. I love you. I've got news for you. Tensions are brewing in Freeside between the ruling gang known as the Kings and the large number of NCR squatters seeking refuge there. The leader of the Kings, who would only identify himself as the King, voiced his displeasure calling NCR citizens, quote, the devil in disguise. He added he didn't want to see the NCR in the ghetto and called for a mass, quote, return to sender.
also in the headlines. Refugees at Bitter Springs are giving startling accounts of the legate known as Lanius, who is said to be Caesar's top field commander. One refugee told us the legate took over an underperforming squad of troops by beating its commander to death in full view of everyone. The legate then ordered a tenth of his own force be killed by the other nine tenths. And you thought your boss was a pain. These headlines were brought to you by Vault 21. Vault 21. Everything's better when you experience it in a vault. More classics coming right up for you, so stay tuned.
Whoa there, Pap.
Each and every one of you is wonderful in your own special way. this just in. Traders from California are being turned away from Mojave Outpost, where the NCR is concerned about dangers along Nipton Highway and I-15. In addition, rumors have surfaced that Topps Hotel...
Hold it right there. Don't you move. How the hell did you survive that bombardment? But I had you zeroed in the whole time. Nobody's that fast. Move a muscle now and I'll blow you to pieces. And just stay where you are. Raquel will be here any second.
I'll take this from here. I'm Raquel, Master at Arms for the Nellis homeland. Mother Pearl, our eldest, wishes to speak to you. Follow close, and mind your behavior.
Welcome, child. I've been waiting a good 5 years for an outsider to come along and visit. Oh, so many ways. Small ones to begin with, so we can get used to what it's like to have a outsider around and about. Should that go well, it may be you can help in big ways, too. We'll have to see. You have to keep in mind that you're our first contact with the outside world since I was barely a woman. Seclusion has kept us safe, but the world around us is changing. Neon lights in the distance, patrolling robots, soldiers. My youngers think our guns can keep out the world, but I think we need to let it in just a little. Or become its victim. You're that little bit of the world, child. Welcome to Nellis. You picked a good time to stop by, for we're swimming in problems. My youngers can tell you all about it. Raquel could use help with the bug problem. Doc Argyle has wounded he's tending to. And Loyal and Jack might be looking for help with some repairs. Or you could just go see Pete at the museum and hear the story of our people. All you have to do there is listen. Come and go as you like, help or don't help, I leave it up to you. But I hope you'll show my youngers that not every outsider needs to be blown up.
I can take care of that robot problem for you. Just saying.
back through that artillery barrage.
Take care of that robot problem for you. Just saying.
Mother Pearl's instructions are clear. You can move freely around Nellis, and artillery spotters have orders not to fire on you. These are extraordinary privileges. Don't abuse them. Long story short, the power failed a few days ago because giant ants have tunneled into the generator room and set up a nest. I led a team down to exterminate them, but there were so many of them. We lost. 2 killed, 3 wounded. Personally, I think it's more than a savage can handle. But if you want to kill those ants and switch the power back on, feel free. They exploded when hit by a flamethrower. One of us was using a laser pistol. Same thing. Bullets seem okay. Just don't hit the artillery shells. Loyal's been working on some kind of weapon to use against them. Maybe you should check with him.
Once a Republican, always a Republican.
I can take care of that.
I hope Pearl knows what she's doing, letting you wander around Nellis as you please.
I started building a sonic emitter that might do the trick, but it's useless without knowing the exact frequency that would kill the ants. Hot damn, you're right! It's a matter of boosting across those thresholds, not exact amplitude. You're smarter than you look. Just so happens I was testing it at 24,000 hertz, so it should be good to go. Place it near their nest and cross your fingers. Signal's too high for people to hear, so no harm done. But it might make you feel sick to your stomach.
Take this. Company.
That shit hurting.
This Mr. New Vegas, and I have a good feeling about all of you listening. More news for you. There's word in from Cap McCarran that an attempt to blow this monorail system was won. Also in the headlines, merchants are saying that there's been little contact between traders from Nipton in recent days, causing concerns that the isolated town may be in trouble. Promotional consideration to this news program has been paid for by the Ultralux. The Ultralux. Live life in the lap of life.
I see the power's back on. The ants are all dead? Maybe Pearl is right about you, because I don't know how you pulled that off. I'll tell Loyal to send someone down to clear out the eggs and repair the generators. Good work. What is it, outsider? The next time you leave Nellis, keep an eye out for missiles. Come find me when you've...
You have done well to earn the trust of my people, child. I believe the time has come for you to show your value in full. The people have come to accept having you around. Find Loyal and ask him about our people's fondest dream. He will tell you what to do next.
It was over in a moment and the folks had gathered round. There before them lay the body of...
Why are you running? Why are you running?
The outlaw on the ground. Oh, he might have went on living, but he made one fatal slip.
when he tried to match the ranger with the big iron on his hip.
Pearl sent word saying it's all right to tell you about the lady in the water. A long time ago, long before the war that killed just about everything that ever lived, a bomber crashed not far from here. A bomber was a flying contraption that could drop explosives down on anything it flew over. But anyway, moving on. This bomber crashed down in Lake Mead, pretty damn near intact. When we got to Nellis, see, I found this article in a magazine all about it. There was another B-29 around here, part of a museum. Couldn't fly, but had a lot of spare parts, see? Get where I'm going? Since I was a young man, I've dreamed of raising that lady from the lake and bringing her back to life. What do you say? Simple. Attach deployable ballast to the plane and float it on up. Here is a remote detonator. Once the ballast is attached to the plane, just hit the detonator from the shore and let buoyancy handle the rest. Maybe you don't understand. Hasn't been one of us, not a one, to set a foot outside Nellis in over 50 years. You come along with your knowledge of the outside, and it seems the time's come to raise the lady after all. Good. Here's the deployable ballast. Go find the plane, attach the ballast, and hit the button. Might try holding your breath. If that doesn't sound good enough, talk to Jack. He was working on a rebreather once.
So you're the outsider. Lived your whole life out there, huh? Wow. I always thought you savages probably spoke a different language. But I hear you sound like us. I just need some parts from a pressure cooker to create a hermetic seal for the rebreather. That's a brilliant idea. I can put that together right now. Here you go. A new rebreather.
Reports say NCR's General Lee Oliver may have uprooted from his post at Camp McCarran in order to be present at Hoover Dam. NCR sources say that holding the dam against Caesar's Legion has become their main strategic priority, and this move would not be unexpected. In other news, Prem, formally sworn a new sheriff today, RNV reporters were on hand to hear the new sheriff address the crowd.
People of Prim, the NCR wishes to inform you that you are under their jurisdiction now. And from now on, you're gonna be living by our rules.
Well, that's all I have for you. This is Mr. New Vegas wishing you ladylike luck tonight. More classics coming right up for you, so stay tuned.
Here you're going to. It's going to be a dream come true. That's tremendous. I'll transmit instructions to the robots to start packing up the plane to bring it back to Nellis. I just told you, the robots are going to handle it.
Thank you.
Kello. What you have done for us is a miracle, child. You have fulfilled the only dreams we ever had outside our walls. You are a trusted friend of us all. Of course, my child. After all that you have done for us, we would love to help you in the upcoming battle. After all the training in virtual reality, the young ones would relish an opportunity to put their skills to battle. We'll be there when you need us.